Welcome back to our SOTI Connect how-to video series. Now that we have our basic installation complete, we have to configure the protocol adapters. They allow any IoT device to communicate with SOTI Connect for you to manage it remotely. Hello, I'm MJ, and I'm a principal instructor here at SOTI. Protocol adapters are used to facilitate the management of devices using various communication protocols. When you enroll a device, you must create a connection between your device and SOTI Connect using a protocol adapter. SOTI Connect allows the installation of protocol adapters separate from the core installation and to configure them to communicate with your instance of SOTI Connect. This allows you to connect your devices from different locations. So let's begin. First, we need to check some prerequisites to make sure you are ready to install. You must have the SOTI Connect installer on your computer. If you're using Connect on the cloud, you can access the SOTI Connect installer from the SOTI Connect website. You will also need the root certificate and password you created when you installed SOTI Connect. Don't worry, if you don't know where to find these, you can always download them from the SOTI Connect console. To download a root certificate, navigate to the administration page and then to the system management tab where you will see a button to download the root certificate. Navigate to the SOTI Connect zip folder and extract the files. Once you have extracted the files, find the installer file called soti.iot.installer.exe and run it. Once the installation wizard pops up, select new installation of some or all the components. Next, since we are installing protocol adapters, only choose a custom installation type. When choosing the components, only select the protocol adapters you wish to install. Next, enter the FQDN or IP address of where the SOTI Connect instance and its components are hosted. It is strongly recommended to use the fully qualified domain name to avoid possible changes in IP addresses in the future. You should avoid changing the default ports unless you assign different ports when installing your SOTI Connect instance. Otherwise, your ports will not match and your SOTI Connect instance will not be able to connect to your protocol adapters. In the IP address prompt shown, you can write the same IP address for the MQTT management and logging services. You can check the Use Tenant ID prefix box if your MQTT device will be expecting a SOTI Connect tenant ID or leave it unchecked if they will not be. Now, you can select the location of the root folder. Browse your machine and import the root certificate that was either generated when you installed your SOTI Connect instance or downloaded from the SOTI Connect console. Next, enter the certificate password that was created alongside the certificate, and that should complete the protocol adapter installation. After installation, you can see your protocol adapters in your SOTI Connect instance. And that's it. In a couple of minutes, I've shown you how you can configure the protocol adapters for SOTI Connect so that you can start enrolling devices and unlock the possibilities of the complete lifecycle management of IoT devices within your organization. Next, join us for part 3 in the series, where we will explain how to enroll devices into a freshly installed SOTI Connect instance. Thank you for tuning in. If you find our content valuable, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates. To learn more about how the SOTI One platform reduces the cost, complexity, and downtime of your business-critical mobile and IoT operations, visit www.soti.net.